This is not about how to tie surgical knots. If you're watching this at all, you probably know how to do that. And you can get basic instruction at a variety of other sites. This is about how to tie knots in the most effective way. Surgical knots need to be tight enough, but not too tight. Tight enough to accomplish their mission, but not so tight that the suture breaks or pulls through the tissue. Conventional wisdom number one is that the only tight knot is a square knot. Conventional wisdom number two is that you shouldn't slide knots because friction will weaken the suture material and make it likely to break. At extremes of force, that is certainly true. However, I'm here with better alternatives to the conventional wisdom, and I will show you why. Start with the anatomy of a knot. Surgical knots are very simple. Surgical knots are variations on single loops of one suture arm around the other, piled on top of each other. Throwing two successive loops in opposite directions produces a classic square knot. Pulling on the two free ends of a square knot in opposite directions will tighten and lock the knot. Notice that all of the tightening occurs within the knot. You can see the two working ends moving away from each other. There is no movement of the two non-working ends, which preserves the size of the loop formed by the non-working ends. Notice also if we take this knot apart, loosen it up again, what happens if you don't put tension on both working ends? If you put tension on only one working end, the knot changes configuration and slides. This is an important point we'll return to later. If you are tying something around someone's neck, you want the knot to be tight, but you don't want it to keep tightening if it's pulled on. In other words, you want the loop it forms to be conserved. The classic square knot is perfect for that situation. It conserves the loop by locking the knot. On the contrary, in heart surgery, it's all about steadily tightening that loop against the resistance of the tissue. You want to choke the alligator just the right amount. To accomplish that, I suggest you forget most of the things people have tried to teach you about tying square knots. Your goal is to create loops that slide like rings down a stick. To do this, put all of the tension on one arm of the suture with one hand, then throw loose loops around it with the other hand. Throwing two loops in the same direction creates two half-hitches, which slide easily. My right hand is the stick, and my left hand is creating the rings. As you pull on the stick arm of the suture, the rings will slide until the loop around the object being tied is too tight to allow any more sliding. Only then does my left hand have anything to do. Pull down and away on the loops to tighten the knot and prevent further sliding. For insurance, throw another loop in the opposite direction and tighten that. What does the third loop create? If you rearrange the last two loops, you find a classic locking square knot. In heart surgery, we're usually tying with suture material that has substantial memory and therefore a tendency to untie. So we throw several more locking loops. But virtually all of the tightening is done with the first two loops. Suppose you forget which direction you're throwing the loops and throw two in opposite directions. You're stuck with a locking square knot, right? Wrong. Pull on one arm to create the stick. The knot flips around, and what do you have? Two sliding loops. They will slide almost as well as two half hitches, as long as you don't put any tension on the loops with your other hand. Just pull it tight with your stick hand, then lock it off as usual. Does it make any difference which hand pulls on the stick? Not with respect to tight knots, it's a personal choice. I choose to pull with my right hand for two reasons. First, perfect tightness is what it's all about, so I control tension with my dominant hand. Second, I can stave a few little steps by palming my instruments, especially scissors or a needle holder. Got it? you're off to the races.